before I could even read or write. My prayer every night before I went to sleep was that death would come quickly. I am a survivor of human trafficking, and my exploitation happened here in the U.S. and started at the age of 4. And in the world of human trafficking, it's often really hard for us to know what to do or how to get involved. In fact, right now around the world, there's 45 million people currently enslaved in human trafficking. According to the FBI, as many as 100,000 of those are American-born children. Right now, the U.S. is the number one consumer of sex worldwide. So we are driving the demand as a society. Often we think that trafficking is just happening in some far-off place. That wasn't the case for me, and it's not the case for many. My exploitation happened in southern Missouri, where many people would call it the buckle of the Bible Belt. So who are these survivors? They're young adults, they're children coming out of foster care, coming out of group homes, some coming out of really safe, loving Christian families and being lured and groomed into the sex trade as early as 11 and 12 years old. I would like to invite you to consider that we all have a role in fighting against human trafficking. Most people don't recognize that pornography and trafficking go hand in hand. And the latest reports out of the church indicate that 68% of men in the church and as many as 32% of women in the church have what they report as a problematic, regular usage of pornography. But what they don't recognize is that when they're on their computers wandering through a virtual red light district, seeing what boy or girl they're going to use to satisfy their lust, the majority of those people on screen are people who have been trafficked, exploited, or abused. And so their involvement in what's supposed to be a victimless crime is actually furthering the exploitation of people, both locally and globally. So I'd like to invite you to consider the fact that by addressing our own greed, our own lust, our own demand for cheap labor, cheap products, and cheap sex, if we address that, that single action will impact human trafficking, both here and worldwide. I don't think we will see an end to it in our lifetime. What I do think is that we can end it for one. Who are these survivors? These survivors are in third world countries. They're all over the world, those places that you imagine, the slums and things that you see depicted on TV. But you know what? These survivors, they're also in the U.S. They're in your own neighborhoods. They're in your churches. They're in your schools. Right now, they may even be hidden in your browser history on your own personal computer or in that phone in your pocket. If you want to take action and end human trafficking, then end it in your own household. End it in your own heart. End it in your family. Make this a topic of discussion so that your children know what's going on in the world. You can get involved today with local organizations and international organizations that are fighting human trafficking. You can get involved in prevention, raising awareness in schools, in colleges, in churches, to prevent human trafficking before it even happens. You can get involved in the restoration side, organizations that are pouring out their time and energy and finances to watch survivors raised up from captivity to be catalyst for cultural change. And when you partner with these organizations, those survivors, they're going to gain a hope and a future, and you are going to gain a hope and a legacy. Together, let's make a difference.